Righto guys, we're wiring trans solenoid plugs into the Haltech. Now, this is going to depend, of course, where you've allocated them in the ECU. And there is a 6-pin plug, solenoid plug, or a 8-pin solenoid plug. The 8-pin solenoid plug has a transmission temp sensor in it, whereas the 6-pin doesn't. I have run an extra connector down the transmission just to check, just in case I can't get a good calibration off the factory sensor. I've got one of the wiring looms that goes inside, so I'm probably going to set it up with my temp gauge and heat the sensor up and check the resistances through the range. So I've got my diagram. Now I've got a diagram, of course I made it up years ago, just copying off different bits of information. And in the plug, we've got, I'm going to put the temp sensor in first. And so it is in pin 1, and then directly under it in pin 5 is the sensor earth. It wouldn't actually matter which way around, again it's not actually polarity conscious, but I'm going to do it the correct way. Now the next two are pins 2 and 3 are power supplies for the lockup and the line pressure solenoid. On the early, on the UCF10s and on the Soras, that comes from an external power supply from the main EFI relay. And on the UCF20s, it comes from the ECU, which gives the ECU better diagnostics. And then pin, at the right at the end, pin 4 and pin 8, or on the 6-pin plug, it's still the same. Like the 6-pin plug pinout is the same, except it's got two extra wires on the end for the temp sensor. So I'm going to put solenoid 1, which is in pin 4. I am going to absolutely double check everything as I go here. Yeah, pin 4. Now I've got it to one of my drive-by-wire settings. Pin 25. I'm just going to double check over here. B25. Grey, green. And it goes. And A26. Trying the A plug, eh? And the B26. Trying to do two things at once isn't always so easy. Okay, so it's white, green, B26. White, green, B26. Okay. And then we've got the lockup and the line pressure. So they're in the A plug. This time I'm in the right plug. White is my line pressure. And line pressure is SLN. Okay, let me do it somewhere to you. So in the A plug, 31. I put it on the stepper outputs and it's green. Green SLN is line pressure, and that is, it's also set to be a ground. So that's pin 6. And then I've put it on A32 lockup, which is SLU if you're looking at the code. I always remember it U for lock up. And then it goes. I've also put the two speed sensors on, that's the rear speed sensor and the NCO, the overdrive speed sensor. I have wired up the shift inhibit switch too, and that is going to Scott from Next Level Motorsports' little twiddly box. That is the technical term, guys, the twiddly box. So there's the signal modifier box, so it takes the digital signals from the gear selector switch, gear indicator switch or inhibit switch, combo switch, and it sends it to a single analog voltage into the ECU in that little box. Excellent, excellent. Here's my transmission wiring done, set up, ready to be tested when the loom goes in the vehicle.